We all know that starfruit wine, ancient fruit wine, and truffles can make you a ton of money in Stardew Valley. But what if Stardew Valley had an economy? Since we are selling the same stuff, eventually these high value items would decrease in value because the supply is so high, right? Well, if that ever happens, then this video is for you. In this video, I'm going to show you 5 unconventional ways to make tons of money in Stardew Valley. But before we get started, if you are new to my channel, please do consider hitting that subscribe button. If you love Stardew Valley, then this is the channel for you. I release a new Stardew Valley video every 2 days, and I actually have a backlog of videos, so there are plenty more videos to come. Let us start off with the world of designer gourmet cheese. Yes, you heard me right. We are going to try to make tons of money using cheese. But not just any cheese. We will be using the best iridium quality cow and goat cheese. And the first thing you're going to need is a bunch of cows and goats. I've placed down 2 deluxe barns and filled them each with cows and goats. Before we start expecting to make money with cheese, we need to befriend our animals. When your animals are at a certain friendship level, they will produce large portions of milk instead of regular portions. I will go over why it is important in a tiny bit, but first, some quick tips and tricks to get your animals to a high friendship level. While you are befriending your animals, you should choose the rancher profession at level 5 farming. Then, when you reach level 10 farming, you should pick the shepherd profession. This profession will allow you to befriend your barn animals faster, and since cows and goats are barn animals, then this profession is just perfect for us. Naturally, you need to pet your animals every single day. But did you know that when you milk your cows and goats, it actually gives friendship points and will cause your animals to reach more hearts faster? If you want to befriend your animals fast, don't go use an auto grabber. Instead, do it manually until they have the required amount of hearts. And then you can just start using the auto grabber. And lastly, the auto petter will give you a tiny bit of friendship points every day. The auto petter will also give you a tiny bit of friendship points every single day. The friendship points from the auto petter stacked with your manual petting and with your manual extraction of milk. Doing all of these every single day when you have the shepherd profession will cause you to get max friendship with your animals in no time. But why do we care about large milk? Naturally, you can turn milk into cheese by placing it into a cheese press. If you place regular sized milk into your cheese press, it has a chance of creating regular, silver, and gold quality cheese. But large milk has a 100% chance of producing gold quality cheese, and gold is closer to iridium. By only producing gold quality cheese, we will cut our production time by half. What do I mean by this? Well, we are going to age the cheese by placing them into casks in our basement. It will take 3 days to age our regular quality cheese to silver quality. It will then take another 4 days to turn silver quality cheese into gold quality. And then lastly, it will take 7 days to turn gold quality cheese into iridium quality cheese. By producing gold quality cheese from the beginning, we are cutting the production time in half, which is a nice added bonus. Now you should have everything you need to produce tons of cheese. Goats will produce milk at a slower rate than cows, but their cheese is worth more. So you should always prioritize turning their milk into cheese first. Before you start selling your cheese, make sure to change your profession at the sewers. Simply talk to this dog, pick farming, and pay 10,000 gold. When you sleep, you'll be able to choose new professions. Now instead of the rancher profession, pick the tiller and the artisan profession. This will increase the value of your cheese by 40%, which is a ton, so this step is basically mandatory. Iridium quality cheese sells for 640 gold, while iridium goat cheese sells for 1,100 gold each. Those numbers are really not bad, and you can make a ton of gold by doing this. As you can see from the single sale, I actually made way more gold than I was anticipating, which is actually a nice surprise. So, selling cheese definitely has some potential to make you rich. But the next one is much more strange, and I'm not quite sure how good it is, to be honest. In Stardew Valley, you can sell your animals, but it is usually just not worth it because you have to buy your animals from Marnie at almost the same price. For example, you can buy a pig for 16,000 gold, and then when you raise a pig and get it all the way up to the maximum hearts, you can only sell it for 20,000 gold, meaning you would have made 4,000 gold profit. Now, that just does not seem worth it, right? Well, ostriches are a little bit different. A full-grown ostrich with max hearts will also sell for 20,000 gold, but ostriches are completely free. All you need to do is hatch one of your eggs, and there you go. You now have an ostrich. What if we build an ostrich-producing factory just for the sake of selling them? And that is exactly what I did. For this to work, you will need to pick the shepherd profession again, and you should follow all of the tips from the cheese section. All of those tips should work on ostriches as well. The coop master profession will cause your ostrich eggs to incubate faster, but befriending the ostriches take much longer, so the shepherd profession is better here. Now we need to craft 12 ostrich egg incubators. These things are quite difficult to craft, and we need 12 of them, but having 12 of them is actually really important because then you can incubate and hatch 12 ostriches at once. There is this horrible interaction with incubators. Your ostrich will only hatch one at a time, even though all 12 are ready. So you will have to enter the barn, give your ostrich a name, and then leave the barn, and then start the entire process again. You will need to do this 12 times. Once you have your first batch of ostriches, then move all of the baby ostriches to another barn. Then befriend them in that barn and collect all of their ostrich eggs in the barn. The first barn is exclusively used to incubate and hatch new ostriches. It turns out that taking an animal from zero friendship all the way to max takes quite a while. And I had a second batch of ostriches hatch before I could sell any. So I guess we need 3 barns for this to work out. To be honest, to really take advantage of this, you probably need like 10 barns, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. For now, 3 barns will have to do. Once you have all of your barns set up, there isn't that much left to do besides visiting your ostriches once a day to pet them. You'll also have to place more eggs in the incubators every now and then. Once you start to get like 3 barns full of ostriches, you will be producing tons of ostrich eggs, which are a nice bonus even though they are not intended as our main source of income here. When your ostriches eventually do reach maximum hearts, you can sell them. Usually you would have at least 12 ostriches reaching maximum hearts at the same time, and each of them will sell for 20,000 gold, meaning if we sell all of them, we should make around 240,000 gold. Now, I am not gonna lie to you, this took a ton of effort, but 240,000 gold is not that bad. And while I was busy befriending my ostriches, they managed to produce tons of extra eggs for me. I turned all of those eggs into mayonnaise, and they sold for a ton as well. I do think I could further optimize this setup and really turn it into something that can be profitable. Maybe I will do a dedicated video on that, but for now, this will have to do. I've been rambling on for quite a while now, so the next few will be much shorter. The latest patch notes have been revealed for Stardew Valley. The link to the patch notes are in the description below. If you are interested, you can play on a beta version of that update by clicking settings and the properties on Steam. Then click on the betas and then click on Monogame 64. This will unfortunately only work on Steam. This update fixed a bug that made radioactive bar farming not very good. Now the blacksmith profession will work properly on radioactive bars, meaning that they will instead sell for 4,000 1,500 gold each. And to test this out, I managed to mine 250 radioactive ore in the dangerous versions of the mines. I turned all of it into radioactive bars and sold it all for 220,000 gold. That number might not seem like much, but that only took 2 in-game days. This method of making gold is infinitely more effective than anything else I have shown on this list. I did make a video on radioactive ore farming if you want to check that out. It is a very effective method, and yeah, 200,000 gold every 2 days is definitely worth it. We all know that duplicating diamonds with the crystallarium paired with a gemologist profession can make you tons of gold. But all of a sudden, the market is flooded with diamonds. What are we gonna do? Well, there is an alternative. It's not great, but its value is extremely close to that of a diamond. Instead of duplicating diamonds with crystallariums, we are going to be duplicating fire quartz. Fire quartz sell for a very low 130 gold each, but they do have one major advantage over diamonds. They only take a single day to be duplicated, where diamonds take 5 days. That means you should be able to produce 5 times as many fire quartz as diamonds. Yes, this method will make you a little bit less gold than diamonds. And yes, filling the crystallariums up every single day instead of just once every 5 days is incredibly tedious, but it does work. I managed to duplicate so many fire quartz that I made 500,000 gold in a single season, and that is only with a single shed filled with crystallariums. But remember, if you are a sane human being, just duplicate diamonds instead. Now we will be gambling for money. Off to the casino we go. All you need to do is stack a bunch of luck buffs. Go on the highest possible luck day and just sit and spin and play the slot machine. The slot machine is actually in favor of the player, so you should always win more than you lose. And when you have maximum luck, this is even more true. You will very quickly be winning tons of casino coins. But what do you do with these casino coins? Well, if gold is on your mind, we should be turning our casino coins for farm warp totems. Farm warp totems will sell for 15 gold, so they're an excellent choice for us moneymakers. I'm just kidding! We will be deconstructing these warp totems using the deconstructor to turn them into honey. All of this effort for some honey? Honey sells for 100 gold each, and this method of making money is just not very good. Instead, you should buy some merkrows from the casino, because you can place hats and masks on these merkrows, and that is just a much better reason to visit the casino. And that brings us to the end of this video. If you did enjoy this video, please do consider hitting that subscribe button. It helps out the channel a ton, and it's completely free. Many more Stardew Valley videos to come. But for now, I will see you in the next video.